I think he raised mistakenly, sir.
তার ওর ওর মাইক্রোফোনটা হয়তো একটু সমস্যা আছে, এখানে কথা বলতে পারছে না,
ওকে
কিন্তু আমাকে জানাচ্ছে।
ওকে ওকে ওকে, আর অন্য সবাই আমাকে শুনতে পাচ্ছেন ক্লিয়ারলি? ওকে,
আপনাকে একদম পরিষ্কার শুনতে
পাচ্ছি, স্যার শুনতে পাচ্ছি,
ওকে। সো সো
আমি বললে ভালো হয়।
অ্যাজ আই হ্যাড বিন as I had been talking that there are two kinds of characters in George Orwell Animal Farms, mostly animals, as the title suggests that it is animal farm, and other categories, that means other categories or characters are human. And the first character you see, can you see this picture? Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is the picture of a boar. Actually, boar is an old boar. Old boar, if you study the lifespan of a boar, naturally the boar lives 14 to 20 years. Okay. But whenever, can you see me now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, boar, naturally, their lifespan is 14 to 20 years, okay? But boar is the same name of pig. So what is the difference between boar and pig? Naturally, boar indicates wild pig, okay?
And wild pig.
Okay, and in another term, boar also indicates uncastrated pig, okay? So here, the main character, as the very beginning of the novel, you will see a character. Its name is Old Major because it is very old. It is about to die and its name is Old Major. And at the initial stage, Old Major gives a speech to rebel against human master. Animal Farm, if you search on the Google internet, that means Google, that means you will see that there are several farms in case of Bangladesh and also in England, okay? And in that farm, most farm are dedicated for several kinds of animals. Animals like pig, horse, donkey, sheep, goat, cows, many kinds of animals are there. And one kinds of, that is the old boar. At the initial stage of the novel, this Old Major gives a speech to rebel against the human master. As you know that the human are the owner of the animal farm, and naturally several kinds of animals are there in the farm. And also this old boar, he also speaks about a song. He composed a song. And what is the theme or the motif of the Old Major's speech? Later you will know, okay? Old Major also composed a song that is Beast of England to the animals, okay? And the main speech, the main theme of Old Major's speech, in very brief, Major wanted to say that our owner are human being and we are tortured by our human being owners, so we have to rebel against our human master. And they have composed a song of Beast of England. Okay, this is Old Major. And
ভালো লাগতেছে ব্যাপার না।
Next character is another boar, okay, and its name is Snowball, okay, another boar. There is a difference. The first character you see, that the appearance says that it has become old, and the second one, the younger one, and its name is Snowball, okay. And this boar next time became an animal leader, okay, and
it is young.
Okay, and for the construction of a windmill debate, naturally this boar Snowball engaged in a debate with another animal leader Napoleon. Okay, and for the debate regarding the construction of the windmill, this boar Snowball was chased off by the animal's dog. Okay, and next time this boar became the scapegoat for the animal's trouble. That means if anything happens in the animal farm, if anything happens, negative thing happens, or troublesome thing happens within the animal farm, Napoleon claims that this is the activity of Snowball. Okay. However, Snowball previously was chased by Napoleon's dog. Okay. He became the scapegoat for the suffering of the animal farm. The third character of Animal Farm is another boar, and its name is Napoleon. And Napoleon became the prominent leader of Animal Farm. And after the rebellion success, actually, at the first stage, I said that old major instigated all the animals, and especially not instigate, he was very much persuasive persuasive towards his speech that they are in a position to rebel against their human master, and then they rebel and they become successful to drive their human master from the animal farm, and they become the animal leader of this farm. So Napoleon became the animal leader, and he gets control all over the farm after chasing of Snowball, and successively or finally Napoleon became an undisputed tyrant animal leader. Okay, just allow me 1 second. Okay, my
Already
I have returned.
Yes, sir.
Someone's microphone is getting rustling sound. Please keep it unmute, or keep it mute. Okay, now can you hear me?
Yes, okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sound kar asche amar mone hoy Harun Loma Isha tinjone
okay. Jara Mehdi Hassan 26, unmute please.
Yes, sir. I want to unmute, sir.
Okay. Dolan unmute. Sadia unmute. Shobai unmute. ওকে দেখছি সবাই আনমিউট তারপরেও কারোটা অ্যাক্সিডেন্টলি যদি আনমিউট হয়ে যায় মিউট হয়ে যায় সরি আনমিউট হয়ে যায় মিউট করে নেবেন প্লিজ ওকে যে থার্ড নেম অফ দ্য বোর ইজ নেপোলিয়ান অ্যান্ড অ্যাজ আই হ্যাড বিন টকিং দ্যাট নেপোলিয়ান চেস্ট স্নোবল ইন আ ডিবেট রিগার্ডিং দ্য কনস্ট্রাকশন অফ দ্য উইন্ডমিল উইদিন দ্য ফার্ম অ্যান্ড নেক্সট টাইম নেপোলিয়ান বিকেম দ্য আনডিসপিউটেড টাইরান্ট অ্যানিমাল লিডার উইদিন দ্য ফার্ম and the fourth character we see that Squealer is
sir Huawei Y7 eta khub sound korteche
e bechara ki e namo nai
tar mone hocche kono cinema hall er ashe pashe ache
বাইরে থেকে যোগদান করছে নাকি ওকে আমরা যেটা বলছিলাম যে ফোর্থ ক্যারেক্টার অফ দিস অ্যানিমাল ফার্ম ইজ আ স্কোয়েলার। স্কোয়েলার ইজ আ পর্কার পিক। We have understood that boar is the old pig, okay, but a special kind of pig that is reared within the farm, especially they are reared to get meat, okay. So this osqueller is a porker pig, and this porker pig becomes Napoleon mouthpiece. What Napoleon wants to say, he squealer with his rhetoric voice, he manipulates the animal's thought. Animals thought a thing, but is squealer manipulate the animal's thinking in a positive way, and squealer speaks in such a way that every animal convinced after getting a speech of the this pig, that means the osqueller. Okay, so he has a very rhetoric voice, and he can convince the other animals. If anybody wants to say something negative against Napoleon activities within the farm, and another character is boxer. Boxer is a horse, and naturally it is another word the critic has inserted regarding boxer, that he is dim-witted. Dim-witted, that means a fool. Okay, fool horse. And this boxer help a lot regarding the building of the windmill. Okay, windmill, we know that in case of Bangladesh, we get electricity from water resource and some other resources, but we do not get electricity from windmill. But in England, you will see that most of the electricity they get from the windmill. Okay, so they established a windmill for the betterment of all animals. Okay, and boxer, this horse, worked a lot to establish or to build the windmill. And finally, what was the result of this boxer? When boxer gets old and collapse one day for his overwork, and then this boxer was sold to a glue builder after collapsing from a farm exhaustion. So boxer did a lot for the betterment of the animal farm. However, this boxer was sold to the common glue builder, especially when boxer became very old. Another horse, its name is Molly. Okay, Molly naturally prefers ribbon and sugar over ideas and rebellion. Okay, actually Molly is not as hardworking as boxer. Boxer is hardworking and Molly is opposite to boxer. However, Molly always loves to get ribbon. That means she wants to she wants pleasure. She is not ready to work hard as like as boxer. Eventually, he was lured of the farm with the promises of a comfortable life. Molly thought that if animals become the leader of the animal farm, then she will have a better life. And for this reason, she is convinced and she attended in the rebellion. And another motherly horse, its name is Clover. Okay, and Clover naturally questions many things of Napoleon decision. Napoleon, as I have told it earlier, that when the human master was driven from the animal farm, Napoleon became the undisputed leader of the animal farm. However, Napoleon became as tyrannic as the human leader, and in many ways, whenever Napoleon did something negative, then this horse Clover raised question against Napoleon's decision. And also, whenever boxer was sold and collapsed, this motherly horse Clover helped boxer to get up and also get rid of the van through which boxer was taken to the glue builder farm. Another character is donkey. Okay, You can also call it donkey, but donkey is the American pronunciation, but donkey is British pronunciation. And he is very much cynical and pessimistic, this donkey. Okay, why this is pessimistic? Actually, George Orwell, all characters are allegorical. Successively, we will understand that what does Benjamin mean. But Benjamin's chief action is that it is very much pessimistic. And animals are very much enthusiastic to rebel against the human form, human beings. However, this Benjamin always pessimistic about the enthusiasms of the animals. However, if anybody ask Benjamin that what are you doing, what is your motive, okay, whatever question is thrown towards Benjamin, answer is only one: donkeys live a long time. That means Benjamin answers in a different way. He says that he will say that, have you seen a dead donkey? If Clover ask a question to Benjamin, then Benjamin answer will be same. All questions, the same answer. Have you seen a dead donkey? That means donkey lives a long period. That means donkey knows better. So donkey becomes a character which can connect past, present, and future. Okay. Another character is Moses, a tame raven. Actually, it was a pet of John's. That means John was the owner of animal farm, and tells the animals stories about the paradise called Sugar Candy Mountain. Okay, this raven always speaks every animal that don't do rebel, don't do anything, don't do work hard. Always we have to go towards the Sugar Candy Mountain. Sugar Candy Mountain indicates something paradise. That means that indicates the life after death. Okay, that is Moses always indicates that. And three dogs. You see, can you see this dog? Ekjon keu bolen dekha jacche.
Ji sir, dekha jacche.
Okay.
Bluebell, Jesse, and Pinscher.
Pinscher. These are the name of these three dogs. And they gave birth. Jesse and Bluebell gave birth 9 puppies. Okay. And before the puppies were noticed by other animals, these 9 puppies were taken by Napoleon. Okay, and they were kept in a storage. And there they were fed cow's milk and others, and successively these 9 puppies became the ferocious guard of Napoleon, and through the help of these 9 ferocious dog guards, Napoleon chased Snowball, as we have knew it earlier. Okay. And another goat, its name is Murel. Okay, Murel is one of the more intelligent animals, as she is able to read. Actually, after the rebellion, pigs wanted to educate all the animals. Okay, all animals tried to get some education. All animals started to learn how to read and write, but goat. This goat learned a lot, and naturally other animals like boxer simply can pronounce A or B or C. Okay, donkey can announce A, B, C, D, E like that, but this goat Murel can read everything, and only the pigs and the Benjamin and the donkey read better than she does. Okay, so the goat Murel can read better than other animals in comparison to donkey, boxer, Benjamin, and others. Its name is Murel. And this is Minimus. Okay, its name. It is another pig, but it has a special quality. It is a poet. Okay, and this pig composed a song for Napoleon. And at the very initial stage of their rebellion, they have all the animals decided to compose our national flag. They composed a song, and the name of the song was Beast of England, and that was also called the national anthem of the animal farm. But this Minimus composed a song for Napoleon, and this song is very banal, meaningless and average song, but that song replaced Beast of England song. That was the anthem of animal farm. Okay? And apart from this, there are some human characters. And at first, you see Mr. Jones. Mr. Jones was the owner of animal farm. But the most important thing is that he is often drunk, and he was expelled by the animals from his farm. And in final stages, this Jones, Mr. Jones, tried to get his farm back, but he couldn't, and he dies for the cause of his alcoholic behavior. Mrs. Jones, that means Jones' wife, flees from the farm when the animals rebel. When the animals rebel against the human being or the Mr. Jones, he also flees. And Mr. Whimper, a solicitor hired by Napoleon, acts as an intermediary in animals farm, trading with neighboring farms. Okay, the Whimper is a solicitor. Solicitor, we can also call advocate or lawyer. In Bangladesh, we can call advocate, but in England, they are called solicitor. Okay, so this Whimper is a solicitor or a lawyer or an advocate. Naturally, he was hired at the initial stage of the animal farm. They were decided that animal farm will not do any business. But when Napoleon became the leader, tyrant leader, he decided that he will be doing business among the neighboring farm. And for this reason, there is a human lawyer is necessary, and Mr. Whimper was hired as a solicitor or as a intermediary. Okay. For selling goods and other thing from the animal farm to other neighboring farm. Another one, Mr. Pickington. Pickington, owner of Foxwood, a neighboring and neglected farm, sells some of his land to Napoleon. In the final scene, toast to Napoleon's success. So Pickington is the owner of a farm. And the name of this farm was Foxwood. This farm is not it's not very good on term of business perspectives. However, he sells some land to Napoleon when Napoleon became the leader of animal farm. And finally, this man toast to Napoleon in a drinking party, in a dinner party, okay, to wish success for Napoleon. Okay, and another one, Mr. Frederick. Mr. Frederick is an enemy of Pickington. Pickington is the owner of Foxwood, and Frederick is the owner of another farm, and its farm's name is Pinsfield. Pinsfield, can you see the skin? Anybody can say yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Pinsfield is the name of Frederick's farm, and Foxwood is the name of Mr. Pickington farm. Okay, and Mr. Jones farm is Manor farm, on which the story of animal farm is based. Okay. And this Frederick purchased some timber from Napoleon's farm, that is animal farm. Okay, and he gave some cash to Napoleon. However, it was found that the cash given to Napoleon, that was counterfeit. That means false note Frederick gave to Napoleon. These are the main characters of animal farm. Okay, and this is the first session of our class. Okay, in the second session, we will try to have the summary of the novel in a brief I will try to finish in today's class. And the next class, we will watch the movie of this novel. Okay? So, any?
Adhan dicche kotha jeno sir.
Ajaner jonno ki break nibo?
Sir, why sir why seven sir? Bes bhalo bhalo sound background e bacche ar ki. Majhe majhe.
Why?
Sir, please, we request you to force him to mute his microphone, please.
Why?
Huawei 2018.
I can why seven lower hands. এটাকে আমি mute করে দিতে পারি. এখানে action আছে অনেকগুলো, হ্যাঁ. Okay, আমি ভিডিওটা চালু করতে বলি. Okay, ask to start video. ওকে মিউট করে দেওয়া যায়।
স্যার ওটা মিউট করে লাভ নাই স্যার, ও আবার নিজে আনমিউট করতে পারবে।
যে স্যার ও হয়তো অপশন জানে না কিভাবে আনমিউট করতে হয়।
না আনমিউট করছে।
স্যার এখন জিজ্ঞেস করুন এটা কার? মানে উনি কে আসলে? প্রত্যেক ক্লাসে ঝামেলাটা হয়।
আচ্ছা আপনি কে? হ্যালো
রবিউল, তুমি ঠিক বলেছো।
স্যার ওর চেহারা একটু দেখেন।
না ওকে,
হ্যাঁ তুমিও ঠিক বলেছো প্রত্যয়।
স্যার গতকালকে ও এসেছিল কিন্তু ওকে আমরা চিনতে পারিনি।
আচ্ছা ভালোই তো, ইন দ্য ভিলেজ ভালোই তো। আমাদের ক্লাসে হচ্ছে আমরা যখন বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ে ক্লাস তো সারা বিশ্বের জন্য অনেক স্টুডেন্ট, বাট আমরা ওকে একটু দেখে নেই। আমি ওকে মেসেজ পাঠালাম যে তার ভিডিওটা চালু করতে। এখানে আমি যেমন ও এখন মিউট করছে, অবশ্য এখন আমি দেখতে পাচ্ছি যে ও মিউট করছে। হ্যাঁ তো ও অ্যাটেন্ড করুক, আর না হলে যদি আরো করে আমরা ওর সাথে যোগাযোগ করতে পারছি না। হ্যাঁ হ্যালো ও মনে হয় ওই নতুন যোগদান করছে, ও মনে হয় অডিও কিছু ঠিক
স্যার আমার মনে হয় স্যার এরকম রেখে ঘুমাই গেছে হয়তো।
হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা ওকে, আমরা তার জন্য আর বেশি সময় নষ্ট না করি, আর যদি বেশি করে ক্লাসে ডিস্টার্ব করে আমাদের এখানে ফাংশনও আছে। হ্যাঁ আমরা ওকে ইয়েও করে দিতে পারবো, হ্যাঁ পিনও করে দিতে পারবো। এনিওয়ে নাও আই হ্যাভ ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দ্য মেইন ক্যারেক্টার্স। মেইন ক্যারেক্টার সো ফার অ্যাজ আই নো দিস আর দ্য অল ক্যারেক্টার্স অফ অ্যানিমেল ফার্ম। ওকে ও আবার মেসেজ দিছে যে পরে ভিডিও করবে, চালু করবে। আচ্ছা করুক। ওকে এনিওয়ে উই হ্যাভ ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দ্য ক্যারেক্টার্স অফ অ্যানিমেল ফার্ম। ওকে অ্যান্ড মোস্ট প্রবাবলি ইউ হ্যাভ আন্ডারস্টুড, বাট ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ এনি কোয়েশ্চেন রিগার্ডিং দ্য ক্যারেক্টার লিস্ট দেন উই ক্যান আনসার ইন দিস সেশন, আর হাউ এভার অ্যাট দ্য লাস্ট সেশন উই উইল বি আনসারিং the questions. So these are the main characters: Peak, Old Major, Snowball, Napoleon, Squaler, okay, Boxer, Molly, Benjamin. These are the characters of Animal Farm we will see. Okay. And okay, now let's move on to the next session of our হ্যাঁ দেখা যাচ্ছে সবাই?
Yes sir, দেখতে পাচ্ছি।
Yes sir,
clear? শব্দ শোনা যাচ্ছে?
একদম পরিষ্কার।
Yes sir, দেখতে পাচ্ছি।
Yes sir,
okay. আমাদের হাতে আছে হচ্ছে 51 বাজে, তার মানে হলো কত মিনিট, 39 মিনিটস। ওকে এর মধ্যেই আমরা যতদূর পারি শেষ করতে পারি। হ্যাঁ দিস ইজ চ্যাপ্টার 1। ওকে এন্ড ওয়ান ডে দ্য ওনার অফ অ্যানিমেল ফার্ম, হু ইজ দ্য ওনার অফ দ্য অ্যানিমেল ফার্ম?
মিস্টার জোন্স।
মিস্টার জোন্স, Mr. Jones falls asleep. Why? He was drunken. Okay. And for this reason, he falls asleep. And Mr. Jones' character is that in many days, Mr. Jones drinks a lot, and for this reason he forget to feed the animals. So it is not an exception. In one day he forgets to feed the animals and got asleep. At that time, all animals are requested by old major in a meeting. Okay, and there old major delivered a speech. And what is the speech? As I said a little bit, that the speech that he said that human beings are our owner. All the activities of the farm done by the animals, but always we get less quantity of food. Our milk, our eggs, our barn, or that means the crops, all are used by the human beings, but our appropriate share, especially our food, we are not well fit, always we less fit, and for this reason major delivered the speech that we have to have one option in our hand to get rid from the injustice of human being. What is the way? That is the way, that means we have to rebel against the human beings. The human beings, that means the owner of our farm, that is Mr. Jones. In this regard, all animals are convinced by the speech of Major, old Major. Here, we can also say that the leader, they have some quality, persuasive quality. They can form the move sentiment, the general people's sentiment. Understanding the general people's sentiment, a leader can persuade the common people in his own wishes. What old major wanted? Old major wanted to rebel against the human owner, Mr. John. And old major was successful. And by delivering the speech, all animals are ready to rebel against their human owner, that is Mr. John. Okay. And he also said that man has exploited and harmed the animals. So our only enemy is animals. Okay. And for this reason, they have composed a song of England. That is the Beast of England. The title of the song is The Beast of England. And this became the anthem of Animal Farm. Okay. And after the meeting, okay, all animal started practicing the Beast of England song, okay, all through the night, okay. And whenever Jones get awake from his sleep, then he found that all the animals are doing some kind of sound. And for this reason, John thought that there might be a fox that has come within the farm. And for this reason, he fired open towards the area from which the sound is coming. Okay. And for this reason, all animals gone, and frightened by the shot, the animals disperse and go to sleep. So this is in the chapter 1, all animals are introduced, and they attended a meeting where old major composed a song for the national anthem of Animal Farm, and the name of the song is The Beast of England. Just we can have a glimpse. We can have the glimpse of this is the song, Beast of England. Beast of England, Beast of Ireland, Beast of every land and clime, hearken to my joyful tidings of the golden future time. Soon or late, the day is coming, tyrant man shall be overthrown, and the fruitful fields of England shall be trod by beast alone. Okay, these are the you will read it next time, okay, if you have books. And rings shall vanish from our noses, and the harness from our back, beat and spur shall rust forever. Cruel whips no more shall crack, whips, nose will be ring free, and they will not be whipped by the human owner. Riches more than mind can picture, wheat and barley, oats and hay, clover, beans and manial widgets, shall be ours upon that day. That means he said that all the crops we produce in the farm will be our own. And in another hand, we will not be tortured by our human owner. Bright will shine the fields of England. Purer shall its water be, and sweeter yet shall blow its breezes on the day that sets us free. For that day we all must labor, though we die before it break. Cows and horses, geese and turkeys, all must toil for freedom's sake. So Major also put in the anthem that we have to make ourselves free from the tyranny of human being. And beast of England and beast of Ireland, beast of every land and clime, hearken well and spread my tidings of the golden future time. Okay. And Major, old Major also claimed that all things he has got from his dream. And in chapter 2, old Major dies. Animals secretly plan to rebellion. Pigs are placed in charge to educate all the animals about animalism. Pigs, Snowball and Napoleon are the most important to the revolution. Okay, they become the leader. Who? Snowball and Napoleon. And Molly's concerned with ribbons. Molly is a wayward. And Moses tells of Sugar Candy Mountain. Pigs unsuccessfully convey the principles of animalism to the others. Okay. Successfully conveyed. Okay. So they, all the animals make some commandments or some rules and principles for all the animals, and they call it animalism. Okay. And the national anthem that we have, Mehdi Hassan, raised your hand. Do you have any question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, what is animalism? What is there in this ism?
Animalism, it will come later, okay? These are the commandments. Have you seen the original commandments are? Okay. These are the basics. Animalism, that means all animals will be free from the tyranny of human beings, and they have established some commandment. These are the commandments of animalism. Okay. And one important thing of animalism, that means all animals are equals, and some other rules are there. We will read it a little bit later. Okay. So animals break into the store shed in search of a meal. Okay. Moses tells of Sugar Candy Mountain.
Sir, one question, please, sir.
Yes.
Sir, can I take the screenshots of your slide?
Screenshot, naturally, such reading documents, okay, all I have sent you in your email address, okay? And if you even do not go to the, do not get the email, okay, there is a link at the end of this slide, okay? So screenshot is not allowed, okay? Naturally, screenshot, if you take a screenshot, naturally, and if you published in any other virtual material platform, naturally copyright session will come to you, okay? So this is the matter. Anyway, so if you next time request me, I will send you all the slides to your email address, okay? Hello, Mehdi?
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Chapter 2. Pig successfully conveyed the principles of animalism. So you ask that animalism, there are some principle on which basis animalism is formed. And the rebellion occurs when the Jones fails into a darkened sleep and neglects to feed the animal. So in chapter 2, we have found that animals are secretly trying to educate all other animals. Okay. And they conveyed the principles of animalism to other animals. And one day, Mr. Jones forget to feed the animals. And then what happened? Hello everyone, if you are not everyone, please mute your speaker. Okay. So one day Mr. John forgot to feed the animals. So all the animals became angry and they break the store shed in search of meal. Jones and his men begin to whip the animals, but they find themselves being attacked and chased off by the farm. So the issue created in such a way that one day Mr. Jones forgot to feed the animals, all the animals became angry, and they got the chance to break the storehouse of the food. And at that time, Mr. Jones and his men came out with guns and other whipping materials, whip, and started whipping the animals. But fantastically enough, all the animals started chasing Mr. John and his men. Okay. And after that, they became triumphant in their revolution. That means Mr. John was driven out of the farm by the all animals. And the trumpet animals destroy all traces of John's, all marks of John's, eat heartily and revel in their newfound freedom. Okay. So all the animals became happy. They eat as many as they like. And also they enjoyed their freedom, new freedom. They have become the owner. There was no human being within the territory of their farm. They are all in all in the farm. They visit John's house. Actually, in the farm, a vast area was covered by a fence, and simultaneously in one portion and one side of the farm, there is a farmhouse. Naturally, the owner of the house stays in that house. That is Mr. John's house. So after their triumphant, all animals visited Mr. John's house, and they decided not to leave it untouched as a museum. So all elements decided that this Mr. John's house will be kept as a symbol of our victory, and it will be a museum of animal farm. Snowball changes the name Manor Farm to Animal Farm. Okay. So after this day, Manor Farm became Animal Farm. And paints the seven commandments of animalism on the wall of the barn. At the side of the farm, they paint the seven principle or rules of animalism. What is the commandment of animalism? What is the rules of animalism? All they wrote, paint on the wall of the farm. And cow gives me 5 bucket of milk. Okay, who is Napoleon? He steals. Okay, so at the very first stage of their freedom, naturally they said that every animal will be equal, everybody will get same benefit as the other animal. But in the very first day, cow gives 5 bucket of milk, and who is Napoleon? He steals. And these are the original commandments of animalism. Okay, everybody can see this commandment?
Yes, sir.
Okay, the first one, yes, whatever goes upon 2 legs is an enemy. Is an enemy. Okay. Prothom principle holo, jara dui pa diye chole, tarai animaler shotru. Prothom commandment. Ditiyo commandment, whatever goes upon 4 legs and has wings is a friend. Okay. Prothomoto tara ei rokom decision niyechilo je whatever goes upon 4 legs is a friend. Okay. To tokhon কাক বললো, কাক মানে যে দাঁড় কাকটা আমরা ক্যারেক্টারে দেখলাম। তারপরে ফাউল মুরগি বললো যে আমাদের তো চার পা নেই, আমাদের তো ডানা আছে, তাহলে আমরা কি এনিমেলের বন্ধু না? তখন এখানে চেঞ্জ করে করা হলো হোয়াট এভার গোস আপন ফোর লেগস, যাদের চার পা আছে অথবা ডানা আছে তারা আমাদের বন্ধু, মানে এনিমেলের বন্ধু। ওকে, নো এনিমল শেল ওয়্যার ক্লোথস, আরেকটা কন্ডিশন হলো কোনো এনিমল কাপড় পরিধান করবে না। নো এনিমলস শ্যাল স্লিপ ইন আ বেড, মানুষ বিছানায় শোয়ে, ওকে, কিন্তু তারা একটা নিয়ম করলো যে কোনো এনিমেল আজ থেকে আর বিছানায় শুইবে না। নো এনিমল শ্যাল ড্রিঙ্ক অ্যালকোহল, ওকে, ন্যাচারালি মিস্টার জন ওয়াজ ভেরি মাচ অ্যালকোহলিক অ্যান্ড দিস ওয়াজ ইন দেয়ার ফিফথ প্রিন্সিপাল দ্যাট নো এনিমেলস শ্যাল ড্রিঙ্ক অ্যালকোহল। No animals shall kill any other animal. And the final one, it is highlighted. Okay. All animals are equal.
Some are more equal than the others.
And the title, can you see the title? These are the original commandments. Okay. At the very initial stage, they...
Sir, regular change is there.
Yes, successively in times of success, successively all commandments change a little bit, okay, and that way George Orwell gave some explanation why the commandment changes over times. Okay, so these were the original commandment of animalism. Does it make sense to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the chapter 2. And chapter 3, farming tools designed for humans. Animals cooperate to finish the harvest earlier than human. Okay. At this stage, what is the problem comes before the animals? The first problem is that naturally in the farm, we see spade, we see plow and all other equipments or the tools. Naturally, these tools are very much suitable for the human being. These are not suitable for the animals, isn't it? Okay. Naturally, in the second chapter, we have gave that the cows give 5 buckets of milk. Okay. Ekon, who will be milking the cows? All are animals. Okay. এবং শেষে অনেক কষ্ট করে পিগের মধ্যেই কেউ এরকম মিল্ক দ্য কাউস। ওকে, সো হিয়ার এট দ্য ফার্স্ট স্টেজ অফ দ্য চ্যাপ্টার 3 উই সি দ্যাট অল দ্য ফার্মিং টুল আর ডিজাইন্ড অনলি ফর হিউম্যান বিংস, দে আর নট ডিজাইন্ড ফর দ্য অ্যানিমালস। ওকে, অ্যান্ড হাউ এভার অ্যানিমালস স্টার্টেড টু হারভেস্ট দেয়ার ক্রপস অ্যান্ড they are in this season, they are happy that they finished harvesting as human being took time earlier. Okay, and among the animals, boxer distinguished himself as the strong and tireless worker, and we know that horse naturally becomes a human's friend, and not only that, horse are called animals of strength. They have strength, and naturally for this reason many machine are termed as horsepower. Okay,
yes,
some machine will have 10 horsepower, that means this machine will the capacity who did it?
Sorry, ei kasta ke korlo?
No, actually I omitted that. Who can this it? Actually slide sharing option I closed, however anyway, mistakenly most probably done. Who has done this, please don't do this. Okay, don't try to experiment in the formal class. Anyway, boxer, as I had been talking, this horse became a powerful animals in the vicinity of the animal farm. Okay, and as we know that horse are very much strong animals and they can work tirelessly. Okay, the pigs become the supervisor and directors. Okay, that means Napoleon, Snowball, not only that, all the pigs who were in the farm, they became the supervisor of the animals. They will not work anymore. Cows will work, horse will work, okay, hens will work, every goat will work, everyone will work, but the pigs, they said the no, we are the superior animals, so we will not work anymore, we will supervise, we will educate you, we will teach you how to run the farm and how to do every activities in the farm, so we will not work anymore.
Ekto age bolchilo animal shob shaman, ekhon superior hoye gelo.
They said that we are the supervisors. We will supervise you. And they said that, yes, more things we have to do. Actually, to do a hard job is very easy. But what we are doing, this is very much troublesome because we are doing the activity of our brain and we are supervising and directing the farm. Okay. And one Sunday, animals listen to Snowball and Napoleon debate on which they seem never to agree. Here in this stage, there is a constant enmity between the two board leader, one Napoleon and another Snowball. What Snowball says, Napoleon says opposite. What Snowball will say, obviously it will be opposed by Napoleon. Whatever the thing, whatever the incident, what Snowball will say, Napoleon will disregard that. Okay, so there was a constant fighting between Napoleon and Snowball. What happened then? Snowball forms a number of animal committee. Okay, Snowball is very much intellectual. Okay, and for this reason, he tries to educate all the animals. He tried to make many farm, many committee among the animals. Okay, all of which failed. But this was all failed by the venture of Napoleon and others. Anyway, but he brings a degree of literacy to the animals learn to read. So, but Snowball did a important thing for the betterment of the animals. That means Snowball started teaching all the animals of the farm. To understand animalism, Snowball reduces the seven commandments to a single slogan. Okay, actually all the animals can understand the seven commandments easily. Okay, they don't know how to read and write. Okay, it is very troublesome for the animals to read a thing, to learn reading and writing. And for this reason, Snowball makes sure the seven commandments for the animals. And what it is? Four legs good, two legs bad. Four legs good, two legs bad, in the common way. Napoleon educates the earth. Napoleon is not less cunning. Okay, Napoleon started educating the younger animals and takes the infant pups. As we have said, Jesse and Bluebells, they give birth 9 puppies. Okay, and Napoleon took these 9 puppies secretly and started feeding them the delicious food to get them healthy, stronger, and ferocious. Okay, and Bluebell for educational purpose. Okay, cow's milk and wind-fallen apples are mixed every day into the pig's mash. Okay. Every animal will get food in the animal farm. Cows will get food. Horse will get food. Every animal will get food. But a difference came in this stage. Naturally, many apples will be fallen for the wind, rough wind in the animal orchard, apple orchard. Okay, so this apple and the milk, they said that this will only be eaten by, drunk by only the pigs. Other animals will not drink milk. Other animals will not eat apples. Only apples and milk go to pigs. That means Napoleon, Snowball, and other pigs, Murrell or other pigs. Okay, animals object. All animals said, no, 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 that cannot be done. Okay, we are all animals, and according to the principle animalism, so all animals are equal. Okay, so naturally we want milk also, we want apple also, so we want to eat. Squealer came forward.
বন্ধ করো, কারেন্ট আসুক বা না আসুক।
এই রায়ান, তুমি কি করলে এটা?
স্কুয়েলার এক্সপ্লেইনস হোয়েন অল অ্যানিমালস অবজেক্টস দ্যাট অ্যাট দ্য টাইম স্কুয়েলার ক্যাম ফরওয়ার্ড অ্যান্ড দে সেড দ্যাট ইয়েস পিগস নিড মিল্ক মোর অ্যান্ড অ্যাপলস টু সাস্টেইন দেমসেলভ অ্যাজ দে ওয়ার্ক ফর দ্য বেনিফিটস অফ অল দ্য আদার অ্যানিমালস। ওকে, সো স্কুয়েলার ইন আ ভেরি কনভিনসিং ম্যানার he said that yes, pigs are doing the most troublesome job for the animal farm. They are making plans, they are supervising the animal farms, they are doing all the brain activities for the betterment of the animal's farm. So they need milk and apples more than so this is the end of chapter 3.
সহমত ভাই এ বলছে স্যার, সহমত ভাই স্যার আসছে।
হানিফ তুমি স্নোবল হয়ে গেছো।
ওকে, আমাদের হাতে 12 মিনিট আছে। ওকে, আমরা চ্যাপ্টার 3 পর্যন্তই আজকে থাকলাম। ওকে,
আর আমাদের রিল্যাক্সেশনের জন্য 10 মিনিট দেওয়ার কথা।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, এটা আমি বলেইছি। এখন এখন এই পর্যন্ত আমরা যা আসলাম, এই পর্যন্ত আমরা প্রশ্ন উত্তর সেশন, ইফ ইউ হ্যাভ এনি কোয়েশ্চেন, প্রথমত আপনাদের রেইজ বাটনে। হ্যাঁ, তার আগে আমি জেনে নেই, পরে কেউ রুল নাম্বার দেয়নি এরকম জয়েন করেছে কেউ? এভরিওয়ান, সবাই একবার আপনাদের ভিডিওটা অন করতে পারেন। হ্যাঁ রবিউল বলো।
স্যার আমার কোশ্চেন হলো যে জর্জ অরওয়েল যে এটা লিখছে, আসলে তো এটা তো একটা অ্যালেগরিক্যাল হলো ওনার নভেলা, তো এখানে যে বিষয়টা উনি বলছে যে হলো মানে এই যে কাউগুলা বা অন্যান্য যে প্রাণীগুলা যে হিউম্যান থেকে যে আসলে তারা মুক্ত হয়ে গেছে আর কি, তো তাদের মধ্যে যে স্টেবিলিটিটা ওটা কিন্তু আসলে ফিরে আসে নাই। আপনি দেখেন ওখানেও কিন্তু একটা ইনইকুয়ালিটির কাজ কিন্তু আসলে আছে, তাদের মধ্যেও তারা আবার কেউ সুপারিয়র হতে যাচ্ছে, কেউ আবার লোয়ার হতে যাচ্ছে। আমার প্রশ্ন হলো যে উনি যদি আসলেই কোনো আদর্শিক মানে জর্জ অরওয়েল যদি আদর্শিক কোনো সোসাইটির কথা, আইডিয়ালিস্টিক সোসাইটির কথা যদি উনি উল্লেখ করতেন, তাহলে কিন্তু উনি কিন্তু এটা লিখে নাই আর কি। ধরেন এটা যদি অন্য পার্সপেক্টিভে দিতে হয়, দেন ব্রিটিশরা আমাদের উপরে বর্ণদের উপরে যে একটা ইয়ে করছে, ডোমিনেশন করছে, তো ওটা থেকে বাঁচার জন্য যদি আমরা আসলেই যদি কোনো ফ্রিডমের জন্য একটা বা ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স আমরা পেয়ে যাই, তারপরেও কিন্তু আমাদের মধ্যে আসলে স্টেবিলিটি থাকছে না, পিস থাকছে না।
ওকে,
কেমনটা ওদের মধ্যে?
ওকে, নাইসলি পয়েন্ট আউট। ওকে ওকে গুড, এখন আই উইল রিকোয়েস্ট এভরিওয়ান, সবাই ভিডিওটা চালু করেন। বাহ, সবাইকে অনেক দিন পরে দেখা যাচ্ছে। হ্যাঁ, সবাই ভিডিও চালু করেছেন। এখন কেউ রুল নাম্বার দেন নাই আজকের ক্লাসে অংশগ্রহণ করেছেন এরকম আছেন?
Yes sir.
Yes sir, I'm here.
হ্যাঁ বলেন, নাম বলেন
স্যার। 105.
Pardon, pardon. নাম? হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ 105। হ্যাঁ আনা, হ্যাঁ আনা, আপনার ফুল নাম কি?
আইরিশ মল্লিকা।